Welcome back to the channel. I want to show you guys how to use the wire removal tool over on the Fusion page. So here's our ending shot, and I'll include a link to this in the description if you guys want to try it on your own. So if we disable our paint here, here's our original shot. All right, so let's walk through the nodes and I'll show you guys how to paint out this wire right here. So first up, we have a paint node. So I'm gonna click media in, shift space, and enable a paint. And I'm gonna zoom out here. We're gonna put paint into our viewer here. And this icon that kind of looks like the spline editor is called the polyline stroke. We're gonna start painting this on over the cable here from left to right. So I'm gonna click on that with our tool enabled. You get the little plus sign and I'll start coming over here. Now, one thing you can do if you don't want to do it with this giant paint is you can look at media in one and then click on your paint tool, and you can see you just get the overlay of your polyline. And I find you get the best results if you really can get tight to where the wire is, this thin line, and then you can always adjust it later. But this gives you the better result if you can get it pretty precise on there from the start. Now, I'm not going to close this up or make it a window, so it's an incomplete line, but that's good enough for what we need to do. What I'm going to do is go to the apply controls. I'll click back over to paint. Our brush controls for the tablet settings, size and softness still apply for this effect. Essentially, what we're going to do is under the apply controls, right underneath color is a little barbed wire icon. It's called wire removal. If we click that, you can see that it pretty much clears out the wire. If we get rid of our overlay here with a command K, so now you can see what it looks like. Pretty decent for a click of a button in one line, but now we can adjust the tool to get the effect to look a little nicer. So here's what I was saying with the size and softness. If we go back to the color mode and bring the size down, what you're wanting to do is just give it enough size to overlay nicely. And then the softness will help hide the effect a little bit. So as we increase the size, you can see it starts to come and overlay. So you want just enough to block out everything essentially. As you can see here, we got a little bit of wire exposed on that side. So I'm gonna go back and shift and drag. I'm gonna have to zoom out a little bit. There it is. I actually had it off. Sometimes I'll forget to turn it back on with that command K command. So I'm going to zoom in and just adjust this left side wire by hovering over. You can actually grab them all, or you can hit this little icon here with the shift. I'm going to lower that down. As you can see, it's now starting to cover the wire a little bit better. Here's where we will adjust softness. And it is good now that we've overlaid it pretty tightly to shift back over to the wire removal. And we'll look at media out real quick, and I'll click on the paint, get rid of our tool. So we're going to look at, as we adjust the settings, what's it doing to the cable here. And there's two different kinds of blend type. There's a crossfade and an edge blend. I've seemed to prefer the edge blend. And there's a distance and an angle and some noise and opacity. I seem to be getting the best results between the distance and size and softness. So I will go ahead and start bringing the size up a little more. I could see it starting to blur the image, and it looks like the softness needs to come down. So if you slide all the way to the right, that's zero. Essentially, it's too soft. And then as we make our way to the left, we're just looking to get a smooth result, not like this where it's too far over and it's getting into where the birds are. So you just got to look, where's the perfect blend between the softness, the size. And then you can see slightly some streaking on the birds. This is where the distance and the angle come in. So I'm going to bring the distance and slide that down. If we go all the way down, you can see the effect goes away. So we'll start from zero and start sliding until the birds pretty much remain, but the cable or wire starts to go away. And then if you pay careful attention to where these birds' wings are, if I zoom in here and I move the angle, you can see it kind of starts changing how it's going to blend. And you can almost make it look like a wing right alongside their tail feathers here. And that helps sell it a little bit better. So that's what the angle does. I haven't messed with any of the other tools too much because I've gotten pretty solid results without getting into noise or threshold. So I will still go back to clean this up a hair because I can see a faint line. So I'm going to balance between size, softness, and distance until I think it looks as good as it's going to get. I think that cleans it up pretty nice. All right, so I'm going to click back here. We'll zoom out. That looks pretty good. Now we need to track this to stay where we want it to throughout the shot. So this is where the tracker comes into play. I'm going to click media in and do the tracking before the paint. And I'm going to go back, make sure we're at the very beginning of the shot here. And one important thing is to make sure Polyline is overlaying where you want it from the starting frame. You should be able to track it forwards and backwards, but for some reason I've got mixed results unless I'm on the starting frame for the tracker here. Bring our tool back on paint 2, and sometimes I've noticed it doesn't always work for me. There we go. So that looks like it's overlaying pretty nicely. So I'm going to click back on media in, shift space for the tracker, and enable that. Now we're looking at the tracker, but I'm going to bring media in into our viewer here, but stay on the tracker node. I have the studio version, so IntelliTrack pops up by default, but you can use the point tracker and it works just as well. I'm going to go over here to the left side of the screen and just park it over this high contrast point where the cable is. I'm going to add another tracker for the right side of the screen and do the same thing on the right side. And then just click track forward and backwards. That's going to give us some tracking info to feed into our paint node. And it's always good to review what the track is doing. So if you want to zoom in on one of your tracks here and step through, I'll go back to the start here and just kind of roll through. You can see it's latching on to where the wire's moving. And if we move over to the other side, same thing. Pretty solid track without a lot of effort. So now before we get out of the tracker, we have to tell the tracker what we want it to do. So I'm going to move over to operation now that it's tracked. Under operation, I'm going to choose match move. And under merge, I'm going to choose background only. And now we're going to click media out and hit play. And the only thing that really happens negatively is we can see some checkerboarding behind here where it's moving the entire image. And that's why I have this transform node. You can just click on paint and add transform right here at the taskbar. And I just pretty much zoomed that in and panned it. So to get rid of the checkerboarding. And that's it for the wire removal tool. I haven't seen a lot of tutorials on it and I think it worked pretty well. I actually ended up using it on that film scratch that I did a couple videos back, and it didn't skew the image quite as bad as the patch replacer does. So if you guys are trying to get rid of a scratch or something that's like wire or cable like, give that a shot and see if you get the same results. Once again, I'll link this clip in the description so you guys can download it and try on this exact shot. Leave a comment down below if you guys got a topic you want me to make a video on. Otherwise, I'll see you on the next one.